Hey guys, it's Worker Brews, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode, where last time I left off, I won the Premier League for the third season in a row. I mean, it's pretty much standard at this point, and I don't know why anyone would be surprised. So, yeah. In this episode, I have the first leg of my quarterfinal in the Champions League against Borussia Dortmund. And there will be a Premier League game in here because, well, normally I would sim it, but, you know, it's a game that I just don't want to sim. Because, you know, I'll be using my second team anyway. I just don't want to risk losing it. Because it's against Manchester United, and if you're new to the channel, every FIFA, as a Liverpool manager, I've never, ever lost a game to Manchester United. And I just don't want to start now. Pointless to give them a win just because I've won the league. I'm not going to ignore that match, so I will end up playing that game. And that will be the two games in this episode. Hopefully I can get a big enough win here in the first leg over Borussia Dortmund that will allow me to sim the second leg, no worries.
This is the Borussia Dortmund lineup in goal.
When it comes to the game at Anfield, but first we're playing here at Borussia
in the lineup.
Dortmund Stadium.
Big reshuffle for Liverpool.
Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts. Most unbelievable stadiums in all football.
This is how they love to play on the break. And shoots. He's gone.
But that the
fantastic start.
More effect. Me at Dolphin.
And they've given themselves a terrific boost for what lies
the fact that
really well
just
really
flew well into the net. Beautiful ball from Renato Sanches. Origi sets himself up and he just makes Berkey look completely pointless. He got close, but close isn't good enough. That's 1-0. That's the perfect start. At 1-0 up in the first 10 minutes is the perfect start if I'm going to get 4 or 5 goals, which is the amount I normally aim for. 4 at a minimum is what I am most... is what I would be pleased with, you know?
Cope with it well defensively.
So getting that early goal will definitely help. Nathaniel Klein wins the ball back. Here's Philip Coutinho. Klein.
He's got his shot off now. Good save from a venomous shot.
Maybe I should leave the long shots to more offensive players.
Dembele.
And not a defender. I'll say now I've scored a streamer with a defender already in this FIFA. Although that wasn't with Liverpool, that was in my secondary career mode with Amcar Perm.
Marco Reus.
It seems like ages ago I did that career mode. That's how long and draining the fucking Belgian career mode was.
They've lost the ball in a bad area. Defender to it first. That's a splendid clearance. There's good progress with this attack. Tackle goes in. Sebastian Roda. Matias Ginte.
There's Drum.
Marco Reus.
And they play four. Here's Marco Reus. Come on, Joel. Damn it, I won.
Be a throw.
I didn't expect Reus to kind of like give up. When I pressed X, I was going for a tackle. But instead, with it well defensively. He passed it. Yeah, I'll play. It's a foul on Renato Sanchez.
Referee.
Yep.
Points for
Renato
it.
Sanchez, of course, returning to.
Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the Premier League fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Manchester United.
Yeah, a lot of people have been talking about this one. Looking forward to it.
Doing well to keep the ball.
Of course, it's not Bayern Munich.
Defender to it first.
Would be fair to say closest challengers? I mean, their closest challengers currently are Leipzig. And apologies, I know I pronounced that wrong, but I don't actually know how to pronounce it properly. You know, I've heard people pronounce it, I still don't know how to pronounce it. So, yeah. The Red Bull team. The German Red Bull team, I should specify.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Also, Karius is returning to Germany, but I think I was in. I think they played in Germany last season. I think they came up again. This is not the first game in the German opposition. You guys understand. I think they.
Liverpool penalised.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I played Bayern Munich last season. That's when I was scouting Renato Sanchez, actually. Funnily enough. So.
And the added time will amount to 3 minutes at least. Attacking well here. He might be through.
Oh, yes. Roberto Firmino clean through on goal. Can he make it 2-0 before halftime? Yes, indeed he can. Get in, Bobby.
Took the chance nicely.
That was simply glorious.
More of a basis for the rest of this match. Well, it is the way the modern game is played, isn't it? This kind of breakaway.
The wrong.
They couldn't live with him.
Oh yes.
This side half.
Yes.
Always going to be a threat on the counter. It's a wonderful finish.
Just widen the margin here.
2-0. Goal at the start of the half and the goal at the end of the half.
Good lead. Good beginning to this.
I want to do better than that in the second half. I'd like to get 3 more goals. 2 at least. You can see one of the other quarterfinals has pitched my fellow English teams against one another. Chelsea v Arsenal. Arsenal fans watching this must be like,
half the second half now underway of this Champions Cup quarterfinal. Yeah,
to 16.
A little bit cagey at times in that first half, but it might open up as the match wears on.
Actually, yeah, how did you make it past the first knockout?
Got the tackle in.
That's where you know. Like, that would be around 16.
Sebastian Roda.
Yeah. For some reason, I'm thinking there was an extra round. I don't know why I thought that. I'm thinking of the Europa League, probably. Yeah, I am.
Good through pass. And in goes the cross. And now the shot. Credit for taking on the shot.
Ricky, that was the perfect opportunity.
By his standards, that's the glaring miss.
Good challenge here.
Good tap. Echo from Mane. Go on, Sadio.
Did well, stuck out a foot, cut off the pass. Quick into the tackle, and the result is going to be.
Apparently, Jurgen Klopp tried to sign Sadio Mane when he was Dortmund.
Liverpool will get the throw.
Apparently, which is an interesting.
Never
fact.
Quite as simple as you think to throw the ball to one of your teammates. Crisp defending there. Sebastian Roda. And it's been an hour of very. Roberto Firmino.
Oh, come on! I gave him a little nudge. You're acting like he hacked him down. Matteo Sanchez.
Oh, chance! That shot's blocked very quickly. Well, a corner to
where?
Come,
yes.
That deflection.
Keen eye saw that it hit drop from and went off of the corner.
Played into the middle.
I bet a lot of you were thinking, oh, here he is. Claiming for a corner. Well,
yeah, they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Oh, yes, he's giving me a free kick.
On the free kick.
Who's going to take it? If Coutinho is over it, let's see what he can do.
High, absolutely not very handsome. Great place to win it back. And the cross coming in.
And he ball into the box. 3-0. That came from that missed free kick, so in a way it worked.
The defenders seemed to lose the concentration almost.
Not,
they saw it
not exactly.
A long way out. The timing
the
was
thing, but hey.
To get ahead of his man.
Hey. It was some header.
I'll take it. Dean Ogre scores his second goal of the game. And makes it 3-0. Fantastic.
A comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
I want to get at least one more goal. Well, two more.
Here's Ali. Good challenge.
There's my goal, though.
On to the attack now.
Mane.
This could be it.
Coutinho. Oh, he's offside. Call it sooner, you fucking cunt.
It's all about timing.
He can afford to give those defenders
seriously
the arm to, you know, because he's quicker than them.
Any layer, and I would have had the ball in the back of the net, and my players would be all fucking celebrating, thinking
so
it's
coming
fourth
down
and
now
out
towards the last.
Oh, and we have one
minutes
foot in the fucking semis.
It's a quick break.
Briggy!
So
off the
close,
puck.
The post!
And really, really, Nathaniel? That's the cross you put in?
Now Marino, Sebastian Roda.
So change shit around. It's give Dortmund a blast from their past with a double header from Götze and more.
Now it's Ousmane Dembele freshening it up. Liverpool, this could be a chance.
Origi.
Shot.
One goal! Hat-trick! 4-0! Oh. Oh, beautiful! I was just about to take Origi off as well. It's a good thing he could win
game, but he's greedy for more in the best way.
Oh, he timed that very well. Yeah, thank you, Diva.
The start, he's great. He's runs off the ball and been top class.
I'm going to miss this Belgian bastard where he's gone. I mean in real life, because he's complaining that he's not getting enough minutes, and yeah, I think it's only a matter of time before we lose him, which will be a very stupid move, but you know, I can't do anything about something that you have no power.
So they're looking for more at 4-0. Well, this is a real shock. You can see it in the faces of the players, and you can hear it in the lack of noise, if you like, from the supporters.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to give their players any stick at the moment. They're just stunned into silence.
Very weak challenge. Mario Götze. Oh, it could be dangerous. Defender to it first.
Mane.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
The ball to Moore. But it's to Götze! And the two Dortmund ex-players team up and put me in one step into the semi-final of the Champions League at Dortmund's expense. Ah.
He didn't need.
I'm not gonna lie, I intentionally did that. I could have shot a bit more. I could have easily gone to the alley.
To try that.
I mean, The pass was meant for Götze. That was the goal. I don't know why. It's kind of funny.
Mikel Merino. Sebastian Roda.
Hey, this is the first time that this has happened in the world.
In comes the challenge.
I mean, ex-players doing well against.
And that's the final whistle from the referee. Liverpool have won.
Wonderful, yes!
And they are now...
Like I said, 1 foot in the semi-final. Oh, beautiful. Oh, God. Five goals. I think I'm good. Chelsea and Arsenal level 1-1. So that
Champions
tie could
Cup.
Go either way.
First leg. Borussia Dortmund 0, Liverpool 5.
I don't know what the like
Chelsea 1, Arsenal 1.
Is. I mean, it's a 1-3 chance, I would imagine. We're along with the other two teams. But yeah. Other than that. Yeah, all that excitement's gonna give switch it around a bit. Because I recently played this team in the for the secondary boys. Take out Ilori for Vallejo and put in. Actually, no, D'Souza had to play that last game, didn't he? No, he didn't. Calabria was banned for the Dortmund game, but he didn't. Neither of those two played, it was Nathaniel. I'm getting confused. He was banned because of a red card against. Who did I beat before? Wolfsburg. Yeah, I accidentally got sent off against Wolfsburg. So yeah, that's why he missed that game. But he wasn't playing anyway, so... Yeah, whatever. Anyway... On to the game. Anfield, second team. Let's do this.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to you all. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. Alan's been assessing the conditions. It's raining. Is that going to help the attackers, do you think?
Well, it normally does. Tends to lead to one or two mistakes from defenders.
Forecast
beforehand. I don't think this line's going to let up.
Liverpool against Manchester United. It's such a serious rivalry, a very close rivalry, of course. The city's not much more than 30 miles apart.
Yeah, well, of course, United down the years have had the upper hand, but... This is a good Liverpool side that we're going to see today, and they could cause one or two problems.
It's gotten to a point where... Side.
Probably one of the two front men will...
I think after Firmino...
Getting overloaded in the middle of the park, that's always an option for this manager.
He's going to fill
his midfield.
They've shuffled their pack today, Manchester United. Eric Bailly. Plays with Chris Smalling in central defence. Paul Pogba comes in for Marouane Fellaini, who's disappointed recently.
Harry Kane
is the main striker today. This is how they love to play on the break. Sturridge! Well, the goal is the game's ratio for Daniel Sturridge. Exceptional.
Well, Smalling should count as lucky blessings. That's a goal, because he would have probably been gone otherwise. He might still get a card. But that would definitely have been a penalty and a red card, because he would have denied the corner. Then again, it wasn't the worst challenge. Serge kind of fell over him. I was more focused on the ball, if I'm being honest.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
My apologies. Pogba. He would not have gotten a red. I don't even think he would have gotten a yellow. Might have been a penalty. What referee is this again? Atkinson.
Danger.
He probably
would play. But they've lost the ball now, and the opposition can get at them. Mata. Here's Harry Kane.
It's been what?
Made the challenge well.
I'm trying to think of what the last
could be offside, and he's flagged offside. Now, Vallejo.
Normally, I'm too busy screaming abuse at the referees for their blatant bias to notice who the referee is. So, I mean, he could have been refereeing Liverpool last game.
Back. Strong, fair challenge, pulls out for a throw, though.
But, I normally remember... I do remember he's very anti-Liverpool, which is not surprising. Referee in the BPL,
keep the ball at the moment.
So, you know, that's part of the job description.
Griezmann.
You have to be blind, not know the rules to football, and you have to completely hate Liverpool.
Very good stop here.
You fill all those descriptions? Fantastic. You're welcome. You don't have to be a greedy sub, but, you know, if you love money, it pays well when other teams bribe you.
Good challenge here.
Don't worry about it. Yeah? You get a nice big chunk of money.
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. Looking good, this move. It's very good skill. He's made it.
Okay, that's going to be a penalty. That's Smalling again. What's he doing? This time he's gotten the yellow card.
And it's undoubtedly a penalty.
But it's a great chance for this side to stick one in the net. And
the second time, this is a much more blatant foul. Oh, no idea what he's doing there. That makes absolutely no sense. That's completely moronic. Daniel Sturridge makes it 2-0. Well, Chris Smalling, I mean, he's really at fault for both goals.
He's taken on the responsibility.
He tried to take Daniel Sturridge to prevent the first
one. He does keep a clear and cool head.
A red card had he taken him down properly. Instead of Sturridge just falling over him, it would have been a red card because I was clean through on goal. There, he says, look, yeah, it wasn't a red card. I mean, referee's probably
just widened the margin here to 2-0.
Yeah, I mean, you could see he kind of let him off like that. I mean, depends on how you look at it.
Damian.
But now, Smalling is on a yellow card, and really, a fall for both of the goals. So, not a good day for the Manchester United captain.
Griezmann. Free kick given against Daniel Sturridge.
Oh, come on! That's complete bullshit!
Yellow card. He's an important player, of course, with the goals he scores.
That is complete fucking bullshit.
He makes another disciplinary mistake.
No, I mean, he's normally their go-to man when they need a goal. So, he's on a bit of a...
Wow! We're evening it up, referee. Fuck you. Complete utter bullshit. Does that mean if Smalling goes, then Sturridge will be instantly dismissed whenever he breathes on someone, pretty much? Because, you know, he did next to nothing to Griezmann. Griezmann falls to the floor, and it's a yellow card.
Now they've got a chance.
Yeah, that
in this part of
makes
the pitch.
Complete sense.
Made the challenge well.
In no world whatsoever.
That's a shame, because in the end, that'll go down as a poor cross, really.
I mean, he was going for the ball. You cannot say Sturridge. He fucking decided to say fuck it and bulldoze those screens.
Is he fit to play?
That's not how it works at all.
And when he does play, he's impressive.
Well, the defence knew all about him beforehand, but they really haven't got tight enough. And as a result, he's been working the keeper, and he's got on the score sheet, hasn't he, a few times.
Well, those possession stats in favour of Manchester United, but what matters is the scoreline.
Yeah, but you look at the number of chances created, and they've had enough to be ahead in this match.
Fourth official has indicated there
will be a minute. 3-0!
Fantastic goal!
Good finish, no doubt, Martin, but what about the play before that? What about the passing? Wonderful team effort.
Well, this is what you call...
I'm in firm control of this, and this is the second team.
A very good moment there.
I mean, am I still playing Manchester United here? They normally give me way more of a chance than this. This is pathetic.
Here's Rafinha.
Perfectly hilarious, but
still so we've reached the break. 3-0, the half-time score.
I mean, they have Griezmann, they have Pogba, they have Martial. They have no fucking excuses, so... Oh. Make it out what you will. Make it
one-sided as this one. They've been very good, the team that are leading, of course. On the attack here. Clear it here. Liverpool will get the throw.
They're panicking to get rid of it.
Defender to it first. Headed down to a teammate. Pogba with a free kick again. Oh, chance!
Oh. Oh, I took it quickly. I died to catch him off guard. But the keeper was the only one that looked. To my bullshit. Hello, not even bullshit. I'm allowed to take the.
Right into the middle.
Quickly, and he didn't stop me.
So. It's a goal here!
And now it's 4-0, so.
And slotted it into the back of the net. Keeper didn't stand a chance.
Yeah, what?
Came close to goalkeeper, actually did get a touch on it. But I think it was a pretty good effort to do that much.
Gets his head on it. Yeah, Ryan makes a pathetic attempt at a save. He pretty much put it in. He may as well not fucking bother.
So they're looking for more at 4-0.
This is somehow Moyes first goal.
Here's Rafinha. Damian. Kane. Manchester United on the move here. Tries the through pass.
And they have Harry Kane. I only have a stacked team. Well, I don't have trouble admitting that. So, the fact that they're losing 4-0 to me is completely all down to
very
that.
Quickly. Daniel Sturridge, a timely challenge. Substitute coming on for Manchester United. Trying to switch on the attacking.
Sturridge, hat-trick.
Hat-trick, goal number 3 here. And it's a perfect day for the player.
Huff and not risk getting a second yellow card from this dumbass referee.
Well, a wonderful achievement to get 3 goals in a team like this against opposition like this. It's a special.
I didn't want to take him off.
For a special player too, a player that is the clinical sort.
Now he can go off at the next stoppage of play, and I can introduce David into the game. Why not?
the stat today.
I'm bringing on David because I brought on Emery.
That's all we've got. A new man ready to come on. Griezmann.
David has no faith.
Strong challenge. I could have got through there, but the defender was absolutely on top of his game.
A few more minutes, depending on when the ball goes out. Play it, stop.
20 minutes now remaining.
I think it was like the 73rd minute. No, it was the 80 something.
Hope you want to stay with us. I'm sure you will on EA Sports as we present the second leg Champions Cup fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Borussia Dortmund.
Well, with the reward of a place in that centre.
Opportunity here! Oh, he had a real go.
Well, you can't knock him. He was in the right place at the right time.
So,
to provide the finishing touch.
About 7 minutes more, maybe? 7 minutes more.
Cleared the ball. Throw him for Liverpool.
Man, you know, just brought on Lingard. He did too.
Good position. They've worked this attack very well.
Griezmann's day of being bulldozed apparently is over.
And shoots!
And Moya makes it 6-0.
And Liverpool have got the goal.
Yo, Man United are falling to pieces.
Well, look dangerous.
But he's just got ahead of his marker, pure and simple, and he wanted it more.
My biggest win over Manchester United was a 5-1 win back in FIFA 11. At this point, this is going to be
a
new record.
6-0 now.
Unless Manchester United score 2 goals.
Chris Smalling.
Even if they do,
this
is still the most goals I've ever scored against Manchester United in a game.
There's good progress with this attack. Well, to keep the ball. Well, no delay here. Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free.
I must specify one game because I've
Pogba
come up against them.
And we have 9 remaining
before
minutes.
In
a substitution.
The Champions League where I've beaten them on aggregate by more than 6 goals.
That would be a throw.
Substitution for Manchester United.
I've done that as a
Liverpool. And there's the interception.
They bring on Ibrahimovic in the 86th minute and they're 6-0 down. I mean, are they going for those 2 goals? Are they trying to make this less historic? I mean, it's already
Manchester United's
historic for one reason. I mean, I don't know how much Ibra is going to do for you.
Impressive attacking play. Yep,
why he wasn't on from the start. That's the problem with having all these players.
Great stop.
I was trying to have them all play. That's why I don't have world-class players all over the place. Now, the only world-class player I have who doesn't really get the minutes that he deserves is
Maradona.
I'm trying to balance that out. No, that's gonna work.
It's a win confirmed for Liverpool.
It's gonna be a rare case of a failed experiment.
One side rose to the challenge and the other has collapsed.
The full time whistle is gone and history has been made. Hey, congratulations to everyone involved.
Important to this derby.
What a brilliant performance.
Well, Fiddy. I mean, I can title this History.
Derby
or something like
2,
that. History
Arsenal
May or something.
2. Everton 1, West Ham United 0.
So, yeah.
Liverpool 6,
well done,
Manchester
well
United
Manchester
0.
Good
Manchester
good
City
job.
1, Chelsea 2, Southampton.
In the next
0,
episode,
Newcastle United
I will
1.
Have it.
West Bromwich Albion 1, Sunderland 0.
See,
so what do those results mean to the league?
Probably going to be
at the top of the table remain Liverpool with 96 points. In second, rising up the table, are Chelsea with 58.
I'll have the semi-final against
third,
the
moving down
against Southampton
Manchester City with 58
FA Cup,
only behind on goal
maybe
difference. In fourth, Manchester United with 54.
I'm
points.
Assuming the semi-final
in fifth,
of
Tottenham Hotspur with 53 points. Put the game in hand and the team above.
Somewhere, maybe
in sixth, Crystal Palace
rearranging
with
the
50
West
points.
Brom game.
In seventh, climbing the table,
I don't know, we'll
West
see
Brom
after
Chelsea,
I
with 49 points.
Second leg,
in eighth, and falling, are Arsenal
Dortmund,
with 48
the
points.
Other teams still in it. Porto are playing Bayern Munich, and Leverkusen are playing.
And then reading up the table, second bottom,
Barcelona. Oh, three German teams, three English teams, one Portuguese team, and Barcelona. He spends giants
with a game in hand on the team above. Fourth bottom, Southampton with
22. Porto and Leverkusen, you wouldn't expect.
West Ham United with 32 points, but only behind.
That's a hell of an accomplishment. Good for them. Anyway, hey, I've rambled long enough. Thanks for watching. Enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.